so good.
You were great.
So well put together.
The downside of it was seeing Bride's shit right at the time while shopping.
Raz, yes, mate. What time are you picking me up tomorrow? Because we are flying to New York!
I've just got a wee notification. Check in now for London Heathrow to JFK, baby.
What time's the flight tomorrow?
Bad news.
Oh, I love bad news, mate. It's one of my top two kinds of news to get.
The flight's been cancelled.
That is bad news.
That is bad news, isn't it?
Why?
Big old pandemic.
Oh, for fuck's sake! Right, what are we actually going to do then? Because I've got 18 fucking days booked off work.
I really enjoyed being in the RV last time.
The RV was good, wasn't it?
Right, just do it same as we did last year. Get an RV.
What, and drive it to fucking Manchester?
Well, there's... What's that place up in Scotland?
Ooh, I like the sound of that. I know what he's on about. Let's do that. Can we do that, Dad? Please.
Fine.
Yeah, bitch!
Stinging bell!
If your friends ask you to meet, you should say no.
God, I can't wait for my friends to get here. Morning, Raz. Are you ready for New York City?
Yeah, love New York. Been there before.
Do you know where we've never been?
Where?
Coventry.
Oh, I have.
So I've devised a new strategy.
Yeah?
I'm just going to roll along with my suitcase out the car like this.
Stop bickering. We're going on holiday.
We didn't have this issue when I was driving, did we?
Right, so after an insufferable journey with these two children in the back,
we have arrived
in Coventry, where we're going to pick up our camper, and then we'll explain what we're actually doing. So what's the plan? You already know, because you've seen the title of the video. Route 66 was a big one last year, and the issue with doing something so monumental is where do you go from there? And then everyone started saying, Rob, there's a Route 66 type thing in Scotland as well.
Scottish Route 66 is basically Route 66 around the Scottish coast of Coventry.
Scotland.
Thanks, Dan. So it's called the North Coast 500, or NC500 if you're in the know. And it's going to be good and picturesque. And then we've got like another 2 weeks with the RV, so we'll see where it takes us. Bridie's excited, as you can tell. He's masked up and ready to go. So day one is going to be commuting up to Scotland, one of my favourite places.
He's got so much energy since he's become a skinny fat bastard. It's actually annoying. Yo, MB, what up?
Is it recording?
It's recording.
So I know we like a bottle of Jack Daniels, MB.
Yeah, we do.
And I know you've brought one. We'll be supping that tonight.
We will.
But I'm also equipped.
Oh, yeah? Show us your weapon.
Why not start off the trip as we mean to go on, eh, boys?
Let's do it. Right, Raz up next.
We've all been tested for COVID-19 and we're all negative, so you can get fucked.
I'm positive.
Oh, shit. Positive for being a sick fuck, motherfucker!
Everybody knows I've got a lovely total 90 bag.
Total 90? Fuck me, how old are you?
Don't shoot the fucking messenger at the bag because it's containing.
No. Just a bottle of bubbly!
A little bit of a bubbly!
Let's set it off now, boys!
Four original recipe, San Pellegrino's, boys.
We'll give you the full tour later because we need to get acquainted with this place. It's pretty cool, isn't it, so far, Raz? You just bang your head, that's embarrassing.
What's the plan now then, boys?
Go up.
Go up?
Up.
To where?
Up.
Up?
Wherever.
Edinburgh?
Yeah, I suppose.
See in 5 to 7 hours.
America or not, this is something that I have been looking forward to for so long.
What are you doing back there, mate? Just having a little nap?
Leave me alone.
MB's gone for a nap.
No, he's not. Oh no, what a pussy!
Oh man, I need a drink, I need some food.
I want my thirst quenched.
He's not happy.
Like a fucking toddler.
He's not happy.
Well, boys, this has been a long time coming.
Sure has. Our first meal in the RV.
I like the reclined position that I've got because I parked on a hill.
It's a bit of a workout, this. It's good for the car. You've got to keep yourself upright.
Yeah, you need it, fat bastard.
Hey.
Off we go. Hold on, let me do that again. And he's ready to drive.
The boy.
Right, the van's stickered up and I think the Virgin conversion unit sticker will get better response here than it did in Texas. So we're not starting the route today, are we?
No. I don't know let's
start the route tomorrow.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Let's get in place to start it tomorrow as soon as we work up.
Cool.
So we're going to Inverness then.
Let's go get some drinks. We're only about 2 hours in, really. It's funny seeing how many people are just unhappy with this sticker on the back of the fucking van. We've got women that drive past shaking their head and frowning, and then lads in vans that get it. So big up lads in vans, and fuck women. Just kidding, women. I love you. I've dug myself all here. You know what I mean. I love everyone, except Mardy people that can't laugh at a joke.
We do love birds, though.
Shut up.
Not been sleeping, mate. Where's the evidence?
How much should I say the price was, Max?
What?
How much should I say the price was, Max, for diesel?
No, that's Rob.
120.
Who the fuck is Max?
I just want to give out a public service announcement on a video that will probably get quite a lot of views. Machine Gun Kelly is an absolute fuckboy. Kells, I'm atting you, mate. Publicly, come at me, boy. Send me a DM and we'll scrap. What? Real talk. Not you, bro.
Raz raised a really good point, which is because we haven't been out all year, we're kind of losing touch with the youth. So we're driving, listening to the top 100. And it's been all right so far. And Dan's pulled through with the Coors Light. It disappeared with time. It never made much sense.
There's a big old clicky clacking on the roof for some fucking reason, and our Captain Climb MB is going up there to scope it out.
Oh, boys!
What?
All the trims come off the side of the fucking thing.
Come off the Raz. What do you mean that's what the hard shoulder's for?
Come off
them.
You don't pull over on the fucking hard shoulder.
You do if there's an emergency.
That's not an emergency.
I think the roof's gonna
It'll
come
be
off.
An emergency when your deposit gets lost, though, won't it? Then it'll be an emergency.
Let me get out and have a look and see if I can.
Want us to stick it down with some stickers?
Doing that.
We're in a lovely place called this. Because I forgot. It's really nice. If you live here, comment below. And if you don't, press like.
Oh, the masks. We need some masks.
I've got mine.
You ain't got your mask yet, homie. What masks have you got, Dan?
I've just got this new one we've made.
Yeah.
Might be getting released soon. We don't know yet. But it's all right, innit? Oh, my Lord.
That is nice. Oh, what's going on with that?
Christ.
Who's that fat boy on there? Wow.
Got another one here.
Cover up that ugly mask of yours.
Oh, that's nice.
Since everyone keeps showing me it, I may as well just wear it as a mask.
Right, so we're going to have to do our like weekly shopping here as well.
We've got to get us like duvets and shit.
Yeah, we got to get everything.
Duvet pillow.
Duvet. I'm excited to see what bed I end up with tonight.
I want the little bed on the bottom.
What, the bottom bunk?
Yeah.
I think that's the least desirable of all of them.
Well, nice in there. Nice little...
You reckon?
Could be cold.
Nice little cocoon.
That's it.
I wouldn't mind having the penthouse tonight.
Sometime today, Junior.
The bastard in a fucking 10 different
keys. Shopping's done, nice and easy. I ain't got myself a duvet, I'm just gonna man it out. It's not really that cold up in Scotland, I don't think, so I should be all right without a duvet.
Profiteroles?
Profiteroles?
Wow.
I thought you were a changed man.
I am a changed man, mate, I'm not on holiday.
You've got, I don't know how you're gonna cut that, though.
Go on, Ralph, strip.
Duct tape, it just rips.
Oh my God, that's so thick. Oh, man, that's thicker than some t-shirts I own.
What's that rash on your ass?
Oh, it's from your mum's chlamydia.
All
cut
down.
It to me, mate. Wasting another night on planning my revenge. One in ten. One in ten.
One in ten. Don't wanna be a monkey wrench. One more indecent accident. At our, pretty much our destination. We're going to get a Mackey's for supper. Me and Bridie have just literally ridden the Polar Express for 2 hours down to Inverness. How cold is it, MB?
Freezing.
That was ice cold. I went in the toilet to have a piss and the piss warmed me up. The steam from the piss warmed me up. Let's get some nugs and get fucking wrapped up.
It's obviously not the card either.
What else is going
to
go in then?
Welcome to Scotland, where you have to pay 5p for a paper fucking bag, and also you get this for looking at the HDMI.
I had a proper sticky poo earlier on.
What's the plan after we've eaten this Mackey's?
I think Dan was taking the lead on this one.
What's the plan, Dan?
Off to Loch Ness.
Where's that?
Where is it? It's in Loch Ness.
Dan's assured me there'll be loads of places to park.
I haven't. I said there probably will be.
So what we're going to do, obviously, there's 4 beds in this RV, and we only do things fair and also square. So what we're going to do is, Bridie has got some straws here, and we're going to draw straws, and whoever draws the longest straw gets first pick a bed, vice versa. Once we're all in our beds, and we've all got our allocated beds, what route are we going on for the rest of the journey to cycle through?
Clockwise.
Dan, why don't you pull first?
Because you've never pulled in your life.
Come on, Dan.
Well, that's a nice long one, that.
Oh, shit. This is fun.
I have that bottom bum.
That's good, because I was going to go for the top.
Which one do you want, this top one up here or this one?
I'll have this one a bit.
No worries.
I've already done some research as well, mate. It's too short, that bed space.
You really need to be unpacking now. And why are you wearing a balaclava?
It's cold.
Running up over next door's garden before the hour is done. Sling him in the cupboard and let's get fucking on the road.
Shut up, man. You're so annoying.
Yeah, because it's going to take me 100 hours to get comfy on the fucking Afghan bed with just a throw, two long legs.
You're going to be fucking...
Well, guess what?
Don't you be touching E5.
23-minute drive away.
To
like the middle. So the lock is like quite long and thin.
My man's down here with Supreme headband, Supreme LV fucking blanket, sleeping next to a bin.
I drew the short straw. Anyway, I think we got some business to get to.
Offender.
I think we got some business to get to.
Are you ready, Dan?
Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come once again. It is a pleasure to announce it is time for confession.
Yo, what up, everybody? All gods matter. I am ready to receive confessions.
I have a light confession for day one.
Oh, a light one?
Because I was unprepared. But it's an honest truth. And
you
it's
look,
something
you
I'm,
look unprepared, my friend.
Something I'm not proud of. Mm-hmm. Father, have you ever seen the motion picture The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo?
No.
Has anyone else in the building seen that motion picture?
Nope.
No.
It's a shit film.
Well, it's
man.
A great film. And there's a scene where the antagonist anally rapes the protagonist.
The protagonist? What?
The antagonist anally rapes the protagonist.
I mean, you said protagonist. You said protagonist.
The protagonist anally. The antagonist.
There's a rape scene, all right? There's a fucking rape scene.
And guess what? The first time I watched it, I had a wank.
Wow.
Cheering.
Cheering what?
Like, I didn't watch it and then rewind it. I was so in the moment that I had the wank.
I think we need to know more about the scene. Could you describe it a little bit more to me?
It's just basically, if it was on kink.com, it'd be considered light.
Allow the priest to interrupt. Tell God about the scene.
God,
describe it.
It's just an anal sex scene. God, what are you doing?
Tell me.
God, I can't believe it, God.
Sorry, boys. Tell me a little bit more about this scene. You are forgiven.
Oh, thank you, Father.
For that light confession.
Thank you.
Good night.
I can't believe Nonny had seen Girl with Dragon Tattoo as well, sexy.
I'm gonna watch it now, though.
Morning.
Morning! Good, darling.
Oh, I hate that. Get up, you lazy wankers.
Coming from Captain Lazy as Fuck, cunt.
I think he's talking to you there, mate. I think that's you.
That is a nice view.
That's good, that, innit?
Put that beer away.
Equally as good as this one.
Wow.
That was like a 20th.
In the group, we call this the RE flick.
Wow. So we've woken up in Loch Ness.
Really picturesque, Raz. Good shout, lad.
Here today, we actually start the route, the NC500.
What's wrong? What's up, big man?
Tickled to make that take here in the morning.
Oh, is that beer that you had this morning not a good idea, mate? No, he's got no words. A man is truly beaten there.
Right, we've arrived in Inverness and we still aren't showered, but we're going to go for a wander. We're going to buy some vinyls because that's what we do, because that's a personality trait.
It's cold out here. You should have stayed inside where it's lovely and not as
one,
cold.
One love.
Well, the reviews are in, boys, for Inverness.
Shit up.
It's fucking wank. There's no to do. Everything's dated. I ain't seen a trendy looking cunt here at all, aside from maybe Danny White, which is really clutching at straws. Record shop just had old records in. If you're from Inverness, I'm very sorry.
I'm Raz.
I'm not sorry. Get a better fucking town.
Well, boys, we did Route 66 last year and we probably climaxed at that.
So we're making no fucking progress because this route is not as famous as Route 66, so it's not on Google Maps and we've got no data. So far, no progress has really been made.
His possessions are safe.
Ah.
We don't want him to lose anything, do
not,
we?
Not just fucking about all this shit, innit?
Nah, I was looking after him, man. Looking after my boys. Driven us 700 miles yesterday. I was like, you know what? Look after his shit at least, innit?
You're a child.
I'm a good man.
A good child.
A good friend. Are you happy, yeah? How do you measure if you're over it or not?
I got that coffee grip. After looking around for what seems like years, we finally found a chippy. So let's go and get some fish and chips.
Daydreaming. They call him the jumping man. He ain't got no fans.
The M's.
Oh,
Oh, tripping over. Yeah, you are meant tripping, boy.
The difference between Scottish Route 66 and actual Route 66 is actual Route 66 got a bit history and it's a bit interesting, to be honest. But we finally found a landmark, which is the world's shortest street in the world.
The world's shortest cock star in Razzie.
It's Razzie, let's go have a look at the street.
Yeah, I'm here to introduce
Matthew Bryan. Famous people have come from this street. Alex Turner.
This is it, by the way. This is the street.
This is...
That's a different street. This here. The front of this building is the street.
What?
Ebenezer Place, that's the street.
This is shit. See how much fucking rain for this? It's a doorway.
It's going to be one of those cities where there's not going on, so they invent the world's shortest street.
Oh, another flower.
Right, you're a fucking flower.
Yeah.
Because you're pretty, and I pick you as my best mate.
Good news, we're at the world's most northern Tesco, probably.
That's definitely a Tesco at John O'Groats.
Do you reckon? Yeah.
We should go straight there.
Into Daddy's arms. Come on. Come on, Linton. Into Daddy's arms. Come on. That's it, Nero. Come on, big girl. Yeah, well done, baby.
That was a bit homoerotic. That.
Good news, we're all horny already. And we're
going now.
Got your profiteroles, MB? And is that basket coming home with us, is it?
Why are you pissing sitting down?
Because I don't want to spill it on the seat and disrespect other people in this RV.
So why are you leaving the door to the putrid, rancid toilet open?
That Razzie's had a shit in?
Yeah.
Mm. It does smell bad.
It does, so why are you leaving the door open for us to smell it?
I don't want to hotbox myself with Razzie's shit.
Well, here we are. Cool. At the top of the country, just arriving at the northernmost point of the United Kingdom.
That's so cold, that water.
Oh my god. Well, it's fucking freezing, and I mean ice.
It's been a long time since we have had a night in an RV park, and sadly this time we gotta pay, but we gotta respect our own economy in the UK. We ain't no fraudsters, and we're certainly not nicking baskets from Tesco's.
Rob. What?
Hi, babe.
What fuck are you doing with his jacket?
What have we been
at? Oh, Rob, you're back. Rob, will you... Oh, for fuck's sake.
I'm Ross.
Oh, there you are.
Oh, Raz, be careful with that one. That one's expensive.
Get us on film.
Right, good news, Dan. So we got this recycling box. This is for all the shit that's written on the box. We've also got some disposal bags. I booked us the showers from 8 till 9.
How many showers?
There's one shower, so we get 15 minutes each. Until then, let's chill out.
So why is the recycling good news?
If he gets a fucking mark on that Supreme Northie, I don't care about that one. That one's already fucked.
I'm being careful.
I don't care about that one, Brian. If there's a fucking mark on there, he's going to get debited. That cost me $3,500.
No, it didn't.
Of course it didn't.
Did it? Fuck.
There's your card back.
Cheers, mate.
Like he's on.
Raz, that is gorgeous, that coat. Gorgeous, boys.
What are you doing, Raz?
Seeing what's on local Just Eat.
Raz, we're literally at Land's End. I mean John O'Groats. Literally.
You get it wrong.
All you're at today. Is your trip nice?
Yeah, I'm having a great trip.
Oh, fantastic. I'm glad to hear it.
Thank you for inquiring.
Cheers, boys. Cheers to the good life. Who needs New York? Not me.
Oh, I just forgot about New York.
How's that happened?
I wonder.
What's your best hypothesis as to how tapes got on your thing?
Somebody has done that.
Who? Who do you reckon? I honestly don't know.
I don't know, because the same man who's saying, like, I don't know, is the same.
Bearing in mind, I was sat next to you all journey, Raz.
Perfect alibi, Raz.
So, I saw.
People go for pisses, get me a drink. Oh, something's falling off.
Boys, I've been drafted early for my deployment to the showers.
It's been good knowing you, soldier. Look after yourself, I'll look after Nancy on the other side.
I'll give her one for you. Tell Nancy I love her.
I'll give her one for you, brother.
And tell little Noah.
Little Noah.
Where's my towel?
Not ready for deployment, eh?
I'm going to have to be dishonourably discharged.
He's been having a go at everybody about this.
Well, I wasn't expecting to be 10.
Why didn't you sort yourself out or in your cupboard?
Men,
surprise.
Watch the North Face.
worth showering.
Now I need to go and brave the outdoors.
Oh, that is cold. It's because we're in the middle of nowhere, first time in an RV, having a home-cooked meal.
Just back from deployment.
Yeah.
It's been a hard time out there. It's pitch black, it's raining, it's cold, it's windy. So I've just rustled up a pizza with a few bits we had left in the old cupboards and that. And me and Raz are going to split it, fiddy-fiddy.
I'm happy, mate.
Tell your face.
Thank you, mate. You've blown up the tea.
Got a slice of that going. Oh, wait. We're just stretching you out, mate. You've done a lot of driving. You've done a lot of driving today, and you need to stretch your muscles. You'll injure yourself if you don't.
No, it's so... That's so sexual.
Oh, no. I gathered here today to witness the coming.
I love coming.
So do I. The coming of our Lord and Saviour. God.
I am now coming. Good evening, children, and welcome back. I look upon you with pity and sorrow from my hallowed corporate box. Then I ask, what do you have for me this evening?
Doc, I mean God.
There's still time.
I made a critical mistake this evening. And I would like to confess.
Mistakes are what make us human, my child.
Get away.
Don't let the light distract you.
All the angles.
My child.
Big fucking nose, God.
My child, hurry up.
Don't you speak badly about God in my house of worship.
What the fuck is your confession?
God's got a foul mouth. Jesus.
Your mum never complains.
God forbid you.
This evening, as 'twas unpacking my bag, I put sunglasses on the side.
This is going to be your confession.
Nevertheless, much later, I asked the boys.
This is a shit confession, man. Come on, God.
I asked the boys who took my sunglasses. And I disregarded what they said. And I assumed it was Matthew Bridie, so I looked through his things in. Anyway, Lord, please forgive me. I should never misjudge the boys.
Your confession, well, PG, is fair enough. And I do forgive you for looking through Matthew Bridie's things.
I fucking don't.
Silence. I give you permission to look through Matthew Bridie's things anytime you lose faith.
Lord, thank you.
Anytime.
Twas not my place.
Now back to coming. We'll see you in the morning, bitch!
Good night!
Good morning. I slept very well.
Since we're at the most northerly point on the country, should we do the most southern thing possible?
Oi, oi!
Oi, oi!
Southerners, shut up.
You know me?
Yep.
I love birds.
Don't we all?
Who don't? You know what my favourite type of bird is?
What?
I love a good shag.
So we had a lot of comments on the original Route 66 video saying, oh, why'd you have to empty the shit pipe without a warning? I was eating. Well, good news, this time we're going to not bother filming it. And what we're going to do is we're going to empty it in the right places. And it's not even worth putting on the vlog because it's boring.
Like the fucking Texas poo saw massacre.
We're trying to find a coffee and it's proving impossible because we're in the fucking middle of nowhere. So there's no food, no shops and no coffee. And I don't talk to me if I have my coffee on the morning, eh, Raz?
Finally.
Please.
Right.
Close on Sunday.
Is this place going to be open?
Hi.
It's closed.
Selfishness. Sewn in the fabric of the teletext. Youth club. It's here no more, that bitch. I broke in traffic light that stopped me from stalling now. I'm spelling my guts, daydreaming.
Please consider supporting this channel on Patreon, because we're about to use this music, which means that we get a copy strike. Let's have a look around the RV.
Hiya.
Hello.
Oh my.
So
normally we do the cribs bit all like nice and cinematic. We were gonna do that this time, but it was so fucking miserable and rainy in Scotland that the iPhone's microphone got full of water, which means that all the audio was fucked. So because it wasn't perfect, I've just decided not to do it all cinematic. But you got to hear the music, and you'll still get to have a look around the RV, but there might be a couple of audio issues. So let them have a look around, Dan. Over to you, mate.
Got this, vent, I presume. Don't know what that's for. Like space raiders.
Is that where you put them? You!
Right, we've got the fridge washer. Don't know what that is. This time they're not so big. 15 inch Amir cans. Proper steelies. No big chrome front. Very boring that, innit? It's fucking ugly.
Ah, Winesburg, eh?
Winesburg.
See?
Tiny engine size.
That is small.
That is very small. Where's the V8 when you need it? That's the outside. Do you want to have a look inside?
Let's definitely have a look inside.
Yo. Hey, you fucking big-footed bastard. Get them out. Get your... get them off. No, you're stretching them. Come on. You've got bigger feet than me. You stretch. I can see them bursting at the seams, you fat cunt. Get them off now. Yo, you've seen the outside. Now you're going to see the inside with me. We're going to start with the God Suite. So the God Suite's up there, coming down into the cabin area down here. Seating area for the passengers.
Yo, what's that?
Listen up, here's a story. Splinter cell conviction. It's freezing cold here at night. This is fucking so cold. It's freezing. Three gas stoves, dead wasp. Lovely. Up here, it's my area. I've got my skips. And then my normal Bockies, Air 2. Same shit. This is partly Rob's.
I don't care what anyone says, New Balance are shit. This is where we shower and shit and piss. Come and have a look. So as you can see, it's not very roomy. The shower is really small, and the sink has got like full into this area when you have a shower, and then you've got to when you have a shit. That's fucking rubbish, but you know what? We make do, don't we? We're all right with it. Familiar territory for me. I'm in one of these tonight. I can't wait. This one's really desirable because it's got this kind of privacy shield. That way, is it? Yeah.
This is nice, Dan. This merch.
It's lovely, isn't it?
Man, I'll tell you what. If imagine if someone missed out on last merch drop, what a fucking idiot they
absolute must be. Idiots. But they luckily if that's gonna come out on next merch drop, then they're gonna be proper sorry.
Imagine if it does as well, mate. Oh, that would be sick.
I reckon it should come out in multiple colours as well.
Yeah, maybe, but we do need to meet minimum order quantities and we probably won't in multiple colours.
So why don't you just get more followers?
I'm trying my hardest.
Good evening. The front of this van is actually really nice, and I know what you're thinking. Why, Raz, are you facing this way when you need to drive that way? And that's because I can't really drive. Anyway, let's spin round on these swivel seats. Lovely seat, armrests both sides, so you got a lovely driving stance. Manual gearbox, not that bad to be fair. Fucking clutch is well annoying because it's right down low. Got this lovely unit up front. It's got car.
I'm not up front, mate.
Oh, fuck off. Rear view mirror as well, which works wonderfully with the back window.
Yeah, it looks like you got great visibility out of that, mate.
You know what, mate? I'll take it. It's not amazing, but it's better than no. But you're thinking, oh, how do you sleep at night? How do you make it dark?
Right, that's it. We were going to get some nice drone shots and shit and make this really cinematic so that Scottish tourist board would probably slip us 10 G's straight into account. Damn.
But guess what?
But it's fucking pissing it down.
And that's all it fucking does here.
It's fucking raining, so let's get back.
It's not as good as Route 66.
Funnily enough, it's not. But we're all having fun in each other's company. Let's go.
If you're having a nap, you've left your lights on. You look at... Oh, don't look at me. Put it on the table. Did that hurt your waist by any chance?
No, because my waistline's a lot trimmer now. I don't know if you've noticed. Lost 10 stone, put 3 back on, no problem.
We call that losing 7 stone, mate.
Oh, we call this Loserville where you're sleeping.
Oh, Brad, you got me a coffee?
I got you a coffee, mate.
Oh, cheers, bro.
You don't like the lids, though, do you?
Nah, I don't use lids, mate, because they're not biodegradable.
There you go, man.
Hang on a minute.
Get rid of that now.
Come
It's hard. Everyone goes to me, Rob, it must be so nice having such a close group of mates. It's not.
Someone's had a shit in the wilderness out here.
You sure it's not a bear?
Do you know how I can tell?
How?
Two reasons.
Yeah?
Number one, it's diarrhea.
Right.
Number two, there's some toilet roll outside of it.
It could have been like a fox.
Nah.
Questionable at best.
That's my cupboard.
Just claiming what's rightfully mine that you stole from me a long time ago.
I don't even fucking like Space Raiders.
What's that in your hand there?
Fucking game of LA Noir in here.
Hey, Jack! We're stuck in! You've not got a phone!
Here's an example of a place that'd be lovely in the summer. How nice would this be in blistering sun?
Yeah, instead, it's not even raining, it's just like the air is wet, you know, that kind of rain.
Yeah.
I'm just getting wetter as I walk. Much like Danny White when you're DMing ladies. Fuel's going alright. I think it's, I don't know, how much are we putting? Do you reckon?
160.
Is that it?
Well, we put two full tanks, haven't we, which is 80
yeah.
for a tank.
And we've been using like just any service station at side of roads, so not like even trying to get it cheap. But it's been cheap enough, hasn't it? It's
been cheaper than America, where the fuel is fucking cheap.
Remember that fucking town, that town when we were travelling to Vegas, and it was like $250 for a full fucking tank?
Sure
they saw us coming.
That's good though, because that's what I thought this would be every day, and it's cheap as fuck.
Bit wet.
It's like you. Rob.
Yo.
Is that not going to break in the rain?
Well, it's the first time it's not raining, which is why we're using it for the first time. But Kyle, if we break this drone, you'll have a new one before you even fucking know about it. Scary for ya. Watch me take a good thing and fuck it all up in one night. Catch me, I'm the one on the run away from the headlights. No sleep, I'm all week wasting time with people I don't like. I think it's not this fucking war we need. Roll me up and smoke me love. We can fly.
Question: who wears it better, me or Rob?
That's fine. It's my towel, so either way, I'm winning.
If you find a dead, stranded marine animal, just email us.
Dan, shut up. Your mum's out there.
Let's get to the come beach. To an award-winning beach, they said. It'll be lovely, they said. I was the one who said that. I want to be here. Yeah, it's not ideal, this. And sea's a million miles away. Right then, so we wanted to go to Florida this year.
Yeah.
And it didn't work.
It didn't.
So we're here at the beach, and me and Bridie are going to get in the sea. Right, Bridie, get your shoes off.
He's got me.
Right, what's colder? Go on, lad, off you go. That or the ladder?
Oh, it's like being in Burley Road.
I'm so cold. Feel these bad boys.
He's autistic.
Yeah. He looks really autistic.
I like the way he posed for a photo then. And then he just moved camera away.
Missing,
fucking brilliant.
You're missing the golden shit.
I'm supposed to be vlogging.
Please, quick, before my feet froze. So we all know I show off, right? Because it gives you good content.
Do you show?
But genuinely, right, that was cold. Like, worryingly cold. When I thought you were pissing about, I was worried.
Yeah, because it's fucking winter in northern Scotland.
I mean, we are at the beach, bitch.
Dumb cunt.
And he gets to sit in front now to dry his feet. He says, fuck off, mate. Get to fuck.
Never leave a man behind.
We have not had a meal all day and it's 6 p.m.
I had a fucking pint this morning. What are you on about?
I have not had a meal all day and it's 6 p.m. and I hate Chinese. But guess what? I'm going to be happy with this Chinese.
I love a Chinese.
He's broke it.
Guys, what have you done?
When was the noise?
When was when we pulled up to the beach?
Yeah, it was at the beach. So you must have hit something.
It's probably just like a branch or something that's pulled it off.
What, branch of what?
HSBC, I think.
Oh, there's not many of them around as well, so
exactly.
It would have been really unfortunate.
That was such a piss poor experience. Not only do they not take card, so the boys have had to wander off to the cash machine, but that guy was a fucking idiot in there. Jesus Christ, that was some bad customer service. Not good for my hatred of Chinese food. He's done the food, no service.
This fucking non-card taking Chinese means you have to drive around looking for a cash machine.
What?
We've got no data, so we can't find a cash machine on maps.
There's a massive Bank of Scotland
voucher. Here's my proposal.
Right.
Rather than going all the way around there, in the dark,
so we
can't
in
see,
the
we,
dark.
No, we can't see all. I could just cut down there and head towards, back towards Inverness.
Let's do that.
So we did the NC450 and it was much better than the 500.
The journey that we're about to go on is going to be all right. And I can say that safely because we've almost finished it at this point.
Internet cafe in here, isn't it?
It's ruining the surprise, and I was just talking to Post Malone's fucking agent. You fucked it, mate. Your birthday is going to be boring now.
I mean, it's not.
Post, hey, what up, homie? Yeah, cancel it, bro.
You've done a lot of driving today.
Yeah.
How do you feel?
We need this.
Oh, it's fucking morning.
I'd love to tell you where we are, but I can't.
What we've done is we've liberated ourselves from socials by parking in a spot with no signal, so we're going to have to really confess hard tonight, boys, if perhaps our Lord appears this evening.
Tonight I get to experience the most coveted bed, which is the VIP standalone penthouse, and I can't even have a wank because there's no signal, and I wouldn't do that anyway because we're only 3 days in. I feel like I'm in a proper, like, cabin tonight. Because I am.
How are we doing, boys? Everyone cozy?
It's quite nice. It'll keep us warm.
It's all right, innit?
Raz, come here. Come on, get in.
Come on in.
Get your head up here.
Go on, Raz. We're playing the cram into a truck simulator. As if this is meant to sleep six. Could easily sleep 16 at this rate.
Ooh,
it's cozy. Terrible, is it? Like,
whose foot's that? Is that Raz? Is that your foot?
Oh, Nikos.
Shit, no, the other one. Oh, yeah.
No signal for 5 minutes. We're already all in bed with each other.
And then eating for about 10 weeks.
We're so entitled, man.
First one out's the winner is what they're playing, in case you're wondering.
Oh, if I laugh too much, I'm going to shit.
Don't shit in my bed, Dan, otherwise you'll be banished.
In bone!
Oh, my head!
Ah, he's got my leg done!
See you bitches later.
Masitarte, Maresito, Nise child fucker. We are here today to welcome and to open the third night of confessions. Lord be risen.
I have a risen child.
Right, God. Forgive me,
good
Father.
Good evening, child.
Forgive me, Father. I have sinned. It has been about a year now since I last confessed. And I've got two confessions for you. First confession.
Do a confession.
Double bill.
I'm going to confess. It's a bit tamer than last year's. And the second confession is, on our way, starting the trip, we took a little pit stop. I fancied a beverage. You wanted a beverage.
Correct.
You also wanted a beverage too.
A beverage, my child, is well received by all.
I'm worried. Why didn't I want a beverage?
It worries me. I want a beverage. So while you were filling up the recreational vehicle that we call home, I went into the store. I grabbed a 4-pack of Coors.
Into the British Petroleum store, I believe
it was. So I grabbed a 4-pack of Coors Light. I grabbed you a water because that's what you asked for. Rob and me shared the Coors Light because he wanted a surprise. And then, as I went to pay, I just put it on your credit card with fuel.
Child.
Please, Father. It's been eating me up ever since I've done it.
Child. The Lord had already assumed that's happened anyway.
Hey, fuck me. He works a mysterious wisdom.
He's a good one. I'm not paying for that, though. That can get took off my quarter of that.
But you are forgiven.
Thank you, Lord.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Good night, children.
That's a bit weird, isn't it? Fucking a bird when you dance there.
Well, good news, I'm not fucking a bird because it's at my mum's house and I'm not shagging anyone at my mum's.
If you'd like to come this way up the ladder.
Speaking of ladders.
Ignore that Slayer TV.
That's how we win, baby.
Morning, Raz.
You bastard bitch.
Sleep okay?
Fucking cold.
Right, guys. The target is be on the road for 8:15.
What the fuck are you doing?
Bit of climbing training, you know me. Hold on, bit of hairs on shore.
Right, have we done the route, Raz?
Stop you. Yeah.
We've done the route now. Route's finished.
That was shit.
It's all about the company you keep. Today, we're going to drive down to Newcastle, which isn't actually going to take that long, relatively speaking. And then we're going to plan the rest of our trip, because we've got no agenda, and it's going to be fun.
I'm trying to look out for him and say, like, put the mask on, Raz. You're going to look like an idiot on vlog. And he just doesn't appreciate me trying to help him out.
And he looks like an idiot on vlog.
Where's your mask?
Pocket, mate.
When you get caught in public without your mask on.
We're showering in a services for the first time ever, like some big old truckers. And if you look closely at this face mask, my cock is actually printed on it.
That was all right, that, wasn't it?
I left my hairdryer in the van, though, so I guess it's good.
That was truly delightful. Nice little services, warm shower, free to use. You had Bridie and Raz talking about the snapped banjo strings extra loud so the full bathroom could hear it. But that just adds to the kind of charm of the services, doesn't it? So now I'm going to change my t-shirt and freshen up a little bit. We're good to go on the road.
We're in Newcastle and we've still no real plans. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a bit of shopping while Bridie and MB, I mean Bridie and Dan, are doing this.
So while boys have gone round Newcastle, we have come to do a bit of climbing, haven't we?
We're doing a bit of climbing.
Doing a bit of climbing indoors.
Here's MB going up a wall. He's going to fucking send it, son. That's a climbing thing. I don't understand why they're tall.
So we're going to have a coffee, have a look for some records, maybe buy some shit, and then sit down and formulate a plan for the rest of our 2 weeks off.
So I don't know if anyone cares or knows, but MB and me have been doing this for a month and a half, coming up to 2 months at some point soon. He's fucking knackering.
Thank you to Jesse in the van shop. Jesse, you're a legend, and so is your girlfriend. Thanks so much for watching, and thanks for the kind words, and thanks for just hooking me up. On our journey around Europe, we're going to try and buy a vinyl record in every city, and we're going to start off in Newcastle with a great copy of Hollywood's Bleeding by Post Malone. Newcastle, what a wonderful fucking place. Love Newcastle. People in Newcastle are nice.
Wingus and Dingus.
What we've decided to do, we're gonna keep the show on the road. We're gonna go on a ferry, which is really exciting for all of us, because we haven't been on ferries really. This is the first ferry I've been on in 22 years. So we're really excited to go to our next location. We're gonna have a good night in the cabin, get fucked up.
This is genuinely like really fucking exciting for me. Like I'm actually buzzing about this. Shut the fuck up, man. Can't you just be happy? Now you've missed the turning, you spastic.
Lifeboats on there, boys. Hopefully we end up on one of them.
Yeah, probably.
This is gonna be good, this man.
Excited.
Yeah, look at that big old boat there, man. Mackie's on board, Kellis is authorised.
Oh dear.
Kellis is too much of a pussy to vlog in front of these non-police officers. He's just a young boy wandering around with a bit of paper.
Raz fancies him.
Raz is parked over three lanes here and is eyeing up this young boy. We're tired. I can't talk to a camera half the fucking time, let alone when I'm tired. There's loads of chalk in my fucking phone from
Oh, it's pishing it down.
Side rim.
This is sick.
Bye! Fuck Scotland. Scotland was boring. So we're going to somewhere warm. I want to be warm and I want to be in the rain. What about you, Kel?
I want to be warm as well, mate.
Truly, truly buzzing about this.
This is going to be good.
It's going to be class, mate.
Oh, this is a unique experience, isn't it?
Pop the popcorn.
I have some popcorn now. Fucking stuff.
It popped on my arm in the seat.
I'll have some tomorrow morning.
There's about half a bag on his seat.
Look at that, boys. Close the door, MB. Look at that. This is going to be sick as fuck.
Oh, these are to get us down to the decks.
Wow, what an incredible adventure these boys are about to go on. We'd love to show you it right now, but unfortunately, we can't put out a 4-hour long YouTube video because it'll take a year to upload and it'll get buried by the algorithm. So thanks for watching so far and tune in next time to see what crazy adventures your 4 favourite boys get up to. Bye bye! Oh, and a Patreon link in the description as well. Bye bye!
Only 7 days. I'm sure they're turning right round and coming back for me. I'm so sure.